Everyone, today I thought I would make a video and show you guys how to make these adorable cakes. And these are made with socks and towels. So if you want to see how I made it, just keep watching. So here are the materials you're going to need if you want to make all of the cakes. You will need two face towels, and I've chosen a white and a green. You're also going to need some socks, and I have some regular socks, and I also have some of these cozy socks. Next, you're going to need some cupcake wrappers, and you can also use some cupcake liners. And I also have a self-adhesive cellophane bag, a large cupcake gift box. I also have this clear cupcake box. And some of these fancy individual cupcake boxes. I'll also be using some ribbon and some sort of decoration for the cake. I have these little cherries here, and I will show you how to make these in this video. I'll also be using some of these safety pins, some double-sided tape, some elastic bands, and here's another option for decoration. You can use a lollipop, some flowers, and you'll also need some scissors. So the first cake I'm going to show you how to make is this super adorable rolled cake. And what you need to do is take both of your face towels, fold them in two ways, as you see me do here on this video. Then place one of the towels on top of the other and just position it so that you have a little bit hanging over the side. Then you're gonna start rolling this and just adjust as you go. Just adjust the ends together and then take your safety pin and pin that whole thing together. And I ended up using two safety pins here to make sure that it stays together. Next, take your ribbon, wrap it around the cake and tie it into a bow. Just for an added embellishment on this cake, I'm going to go ahead and pin one of these cherries onto the ribbon. So I just used one of my safety pins. I passed that through the bow and then I just pinned the cherry in place. And isn't that just adorable? And now I'm going to show you how I made these adorable little cherries. I took a piece of baking paper so that I can protect my surface. Next, I took two of these holly berries. I'm going to be painting that wire with some nail polish, and I've chosen a green tone that I think would look good. I ended up painting a second coat once the first coat had dried. Next, take a piece of regular printer paper and paint over with that same nail varnish. Once again, I allowed that first coat to dry and ended up painting another coat on top. Once the whole thing dried, I turned it around and I painted the back of that area as well. Once the nail varnish has dried on the paper, go ahead and take your scissors and cut out a leaf shape. Next, trim the excess wire from the holly berries and twist the ends together. Once I've done that, I just went ahead and added some more of that nail polish onto the wire, and then I placed my leaf over top and allowed that to dry, and that basically just glues that together. And that is your little cherry complete. So to finish off this rolled cake, all I did was I placed that into a cello bag and then I sealed the ends, and that is ready to be given as a gift. And next, I'm going to be showing you how to make this adorable sock cupcake. Take your cozy sock or fuzzy sock and split them up. Just take one of them at a time and fold that in half and then start rolling. And just make sure that the sides look neat. So just pick them up and just keep rolling that until you're happy with it. Then go ahead and take your lollipop and just push that into the center of the cupcake. And just to hold that together, take an elastic band and place it around the sock. Next, take your cupcake wrapper and just put that together. I ended up using a little bit of tape to hold that together. And simply place that inside your cupcake wrapper, and that cupcake is complete. You can then go ahead and place that inside a cupcake presentation box or present it in any other way you would like, and seal that off, and your gift is ready. And for the sake of time, I have already made an extra cupcake, and I'm just going to go ahead and place that inside one of these presentation boxes so that you guys can see how that looks, and it just looks simply adorable. Next, I'm going to show you how to make this adorable sock cupcake using regular socks. So take your socks, and what I like to do is I like to take different colored socks, so place them one on top of the other, and just as before, you're going to fold that in half and start rolling. Place your elastic band once you're happy with the shape, and then go ahead and use a flower to decorate. You can use anything you want, really. I'm just using a couple of things here as an example. Then take your cupcake liner and place that inside. And you can use some double-sided tape if you feel like you need to, and that will just stay in place. I ended up placing that whole thing inside a cupcake wrapper. Next, I wanted to share with you all this super adorable idea. So instead of giving just the one pair of socks as a gift, you could go ahead and buy one of these larger cupcake presentation boxes and place all of your cakes inside and close that off, and your gift is completed. Or alternatively, you could make this into an even more luxurious gift if you add some cosmetics. So in this video here, you can see I'm adding some bubble bath, some body butter, and also a bath fizz. And this is just super adorable, and I'm sure anybody would like a gift like this. It's so personalized, it's handmade, and I am sure this is going to be very much appreciated. And just one last tip, when you're giving this as a gift, just make sure you're giving both of the socks to the same person. The last thing you want is someone walking around with an odd pair of socks. Anyway, I really hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and have fun creating this special gift for someone special in your life. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll catch you guys next time. Bye! I hope you liked this video. If you did, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that you can receive updates when I post new videos. And also, if you could take a minute to click the like button, that would really help this channel and show some support. Thanks for watching. Bye!